Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7.5 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day in the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Take action on your ideas. Doing your best means to take action upon your ideas. You can have many great ideas in your head, but without action upon an idea, there'd be no manifestation, no results, and no reward. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 40, NASDAQ is up 96, S&P's off 1.5, gold contract down $18, trading at $16.91 an ounce. You got silver off a penny, $15.10 an ounce. Light sweet crude off 63 cents, $23.93 a barrel, notes and bonds. You got the 10-year right now trading down 10 ticks, 138.17. The 30-year off a point plus 19 ticks at 178.22, and King Dollar. King Dollar's up 378 ticks, trading 100.08. The euro is out here at 108. The yen is at 106, and the British pound is at 123 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. What do you have? You got a sideways market out here, folks, with a contraction of volume in a big way. S&Ps, you get the SPYs up 21 cents. Bottom line, you get 50 million shares traded. We had yesterday at 78, 9 million shares. We won't even do that. Bottom line, we'll see where this thing closes, but you have a lot less buyers than there are sellers out there. NDX 100, this is going to be the real subtle one, folks. The reason I'm saying that is this, is that 220.04 is the number that you're going to be looking at coming into the close. We're at 220.22 right now. Yesterday, inside the NDX, which has been the strongest index for a long period of time, we failed on price and volume yesterday. Yesterday, you got up to the price point of 220.14. You closed at 217.66, and you had a monster contraction of volume. We're going into the 43 million shares, folks. That's where it failed on price and volume. Yesterday we did 37. Right now you're at 29. So bottom line, I suspect we're going to do 37, 38. The real question is going to be, where do we close? Do we close over that 220.04? If you close over 220.04, that's saying you have higher price. You close underneath that, that's another failure in price, failure in volume. Gold contract out here, still building cause for higher price. What we have in the gold market, bottom line, this thing has been consolidating. We bring this back, consolidating since it broke topside on the 7th of April. Bottom line, you're at 1691 right now, and you're backing down right now with 190,000 contracts. You're going into 249. So 249, the low there was when it was testing the first breakout area, which is the 1666. We got down to 1676 last week. It rejected that lower price. Right now we get down to 1683 today. Bottom line, gold's in an ABC structure on the way up, and that should bring gold somewhere up into the 1800s. Notes and bonds. This is the first day, folks, that we got movement on the way down. If we go into the TLT first, you'll see what I'm talking about. What you had out here, yesterday you had a small gap down. Today you get a larger gap down. The TLT is down $3.10. You got 11 million shares traded. You can see yesterday we did 7 million. And before that, you were doing 7, 8, 9 million for the past month. Okay, so this is the first time that we actually have movement inside of the debt market. I suspect what that's all about is that the Treasury came out, bottom line, yesterday, talking about that they're going to be pushing out notes, bonds, fives, tens, thirties, to the tune of a $2.99 trillion. Yes, that's going to be the financing coming out right up until June, folks. Okay, you can see this 30-year, we did 230,000 contracts out here today. It's going after this little swing point out here of 177.14. We're at 178.15 right now. So bottom line, I expect as this refunding is happening, you know, that big number there, folks, is the number that has been pushed out for the COVID-19. You know, right now it's 0.7%. In the 10-year, I expect we're going to see that thing start rising. I don't see anything exponential, but I definitely do see it rising. King Dollar. What do we have with King Dollar out here? King Dollar right now trading up 380 ticks. You're at 100.08. King Dollar's been in consolidation for quite some time. We take a look at King Dollar. That you can bring that also back to the beginning of March. My take is that King Dollar is building cars to try to get into this 96 area. That being said, what we just did out here today is this. We got back in the higher range once again. Anything over 99, 910 is the higher range inside the dollar index, okay? And if we go over and look at the culprit, it's going to be the euro. The euro, bottom line, down 36 ticks out here today. The euro just went from a 110.18 to 108.03. We'll see where this euro wants to go. The other side of that, if you happen to be inside the metals market, this is a real positive for the metals market. We've had Japan closed. They're on holiday the whole week. That being said, the yen has given it up in a big way. The yen just broke its consolidation about a week ago. We just went from 107 to 106.07. And what does happen is that when that yen wants stronger price, which the lower that it goes, the stronger it is according in relationship to the U.S. dollar. Right now, it's 100 yen dollars to one U.S. dollar. Last low out here is 101 yen to one U.S. dollar. If that's what we get, you are going to see this consolidation that we've been in. And many of the currencies, folks, as well as the note and bond market, as well as the metals market, okay? We've had a sideways move out here. That sideways move has been in place for about 45 days right now. And what I do expect we're going to see is that we're going to expect to see some of that moving. Some of the higher volume equities out here today, we got Norwegian Cruise Lines. That's the highest volume equity out here. That's up 9 cents. You got GE down 15. We got Occidental off 144. You get Pinterest down. They come out with numbers not that great, down $3. Beyond Meat, they come out with numbers, and that's up $24. Stay right there, folks. We got Fred Earnest coming up next, the CEO and president of Vista Gold. Come right back.